Hope the others have woken up by now and reached the venue in another 5-10 minutes. Let's start. Okay, so first let me tell you, I'm going to talk about smartphone ophthalmic photography. I just want a show of hands, how many of you here are using smartphones to do ophthalmic photography? I see one, I see two, three, four, five. If you're doing a lot more advanced thing, you can raise both hands. Only five. So five out of, okay, it's a good number. Good percentage, right? So let's talk about financial interest. I have no financial interest in this. I do a lot of smartphone photography. I use a commercially available slit lamp adapter, which is available on Amazon. No financial interest. I haven't made it. I am not selling it. I have made a few apps, one of which is a 3D atlas of ophthalmology. All my apps are free and without ads. You can download it for free. Let's talk about why you need to click photos. You need photos for documentation. You can take expert opinion. You can do teleophthalmology. You can monitor the progression or regression of corneal ulcers and other diseases. You can show patients their ophthalmic condition. It's a very powerful tool because you tell the patient that you have diabetic retinopathy or you have any particular disease. They will not believe you. They are like, the media has told me that doctors cannot be trusted. I don't trust you. You click a photograph, show them there, right then and there, they'll be happy. They'll be like, okay, this doctor knows what he's talking about. So that is very powerful, very understated. And I have used software to measure the area of lesions. I suppose many of you have seen it done in research. But you can do it on your smartphone also. I'll talk about that. Why smartphone imaging? Because the best camera is the one that is with you. If you have a multi-million dollar camera sitting in your office, but you are not using it, you don't have it with you, it is not at all worth, it's worthless. So if you have a decent smartphone, you can take pretty good photographs. These photos are taken by a smartphone which is 4 or 5 generations back. So this is OnePlus 3T, no financial interest. OnePlus 5, OnePlus 5T, OnePlus 6, OnePlus 6 Pro, 7, 7T Plus, Pro XL, all have come out. So this is that many generations back, and I get good photos with that phone. You can do all these things on a smartphone, which you cannot do on a slit lamp camera. Gonioscopy, optic disc photos, and all these are important in glaucoma. Can you do this? Some of this, yes. You can check progression from previous photographs, especially in an institute where one doctor sees a patient one day and the next session somebody else sees the same patient. It's not possible to, you know, believe the written documentation. You need photographic evidence. Photos, or you won't believe it. So it's very important. Cornea, lots of things. You can take all these types of photographs. You can do tear breakup time. You can do specular photos with a smartphone. You can use adapters if you want. I personally use this adapter. All these adapters are available. But I use the adapter only for videos, for gonioscopy, for 90D. For just a simple photograph, I don't use adapter. I just use directly with my hand. This is even possible to fit onto a surgical microscope, especially in a teaching institute, if you have an observer scope, which we usually have, but no camera, which is what the case was in the place where I was being trained. We can attach a camera, that is your smartphone camera, to the observer scope, record your surgeries. The postgraduates, the fellows can record their surgeries through the observer scope and review them at a quality better than the one which is given by the expensive surgical microscope camera, and it is portable. So this is the adapter. I'll just show you a video of how to fix that. So this is how you fix it. You open up the part of the adapter where you can hold the phone by opening that knob, fix the phone there, making sure that the buttons of the phone are not pressed. phones have buttons in various different positions, so adjust accordingly. Adjust this so that the camera is relatively centered. You're going to center it again. Note the screw at the back. You need to loosen that screw again. After you fix it onto the eyepiece, you need to loosen that screw a little bit after you fix it. So here you see that it's not centered very well. And also you see there's a reflection here. This reflection is because of the room lamps. So either turn off the room lights, or if you are putting in bright illumination, diffuse illumination, doesn't matter. See, that is because of the room lights that was there. Just check your focus, check your illumination, check your centration. Centration, I think I didn't show you, but you adjust that. And then diffuse illumination, very easy, very simple. You just focus and you can take a photograph. Slit, slightly more difficult. You need to touch to focus. That is the only difficult part. You need to touch to focus. Long press, the focus will lock there, then you can adjust the brightness. All of you have decent smartphones. I guess you can try it out with focus lock by long pressing after looking through the camera. These are some camera apps. So now is the time to use your smartphones. Take a photo of the screen. Use these apps if your default camera app is not good enough. Most of the default camera apps are good enough. This is for those who believe that their phone camera app has too many beauty modes and AI modes and all the other things which mess up your photos. This is if you want to take a good photograph, you can adjust the settings manually. So next page. These are, so all the photographs in this are smartphone photographs, okay? This is a foreign body. So these are the settings. Click again. Flash should be off. HDR should be off. Portrait mode, beautification mode, all those things should be off, definitely off. So then touch to focus should be on. Touch to focus will be there in your settings. Metering, you can put it on touch, or you can put it center weighted. So if you know what metering is, do that, or just keep it in auto, doesn't matter. Zoom in. After you adjust, zoom in further, and you can see your, you have to frame it. You have to frame what you want to take. Okay? If you forget to frame it, you can always crop it later, doesn't matter. Slit lamp light should be comfortable for the patient also. So mind that. If you take more time, it will be irritating for the patient. Room light should be off. So advanced settings, exposure, focus, click again. Exposure, focus, white balance, ISO, shutter speed. These are only for the advanced. I see nobody had raised both their hands, so I guess nobody here wants to do this. Or take a photograph and you can have a look later. Exposure should be low, depending on the brightness of the slit lamp. So if you put the brightness very low, then you can put exposure a little high. Patient is having a lot of photophobia, you can do that. Focus, touch to focus, manual focus also possible if your touch to focus doesn't focus on what you want. Change to the white balance, which is the relevant one for your slit lamp. Yellow means incandescent, white means fluorescent. ISO, keep it at low if you can. If you keep it at low, the brightness of the photographs will be low, but the quality will be better. If you keep it at high, it will work even in low light, but there'll be a lot of grains. Shutter speed, faster is better, but adjust to a level where you get a good quality photograph. Slit images are more difficult than diffuse. You can do all this by focusing correctly and touching the image and focusing. Long touch to lock the focus, adjust up and down or side to side or rotate depending on your phone software. See, did you see this? This is a sunken nucleus. Okay, so this is pseudo exfoliation in the angle. This is not a gonioscope image, this is a slit image. This is unfortunately a focal decimate membrane detachment at the point of laser PI by a fellow there. So this was fine. This could not be taken by a regular slit lamp camera. This had to be touched, focused, adjusted on the brightness to take, because the camera which we have there was probably not the latest one. So the phone gave better photos. So if you take a photo like this, forget to crop, you can crop it later. You don't need this glare. Unless you're going for a lens flare effect, you don't need this glare. You want this. This is your subject. put it at where you want and crop the image, adjust the exposure, contrast, saturation, highlight, shadows. Pro tip, increase the saturation a bit, the photos will look beautiful, okay? It'll look very colorful. Corneal dystrophies, make sure the light is at an angle. Don't take a straight on light. Move the illumination so that the glare is out of the way. Decimate tears, difficult to take. Take it at a parallelepiped. Keep it slanting. Try to have a dark background by keeping the slit at a wide angle. Okay, lighting is very important. This is a PPC. Same PPC, you just adjust the light a little bit, you can see the fishtail into the vitreous. So this is the importance of lighting. Traumatic cataract, half a star. Anteriorly subluxated crystalline lens. You can see the shadows. You need to adjust the light just right. This all shows the importance of lighting. Then this is what you have been waiting for, the specular reflection. Not as good as the specular camera, but you can get pictures of the guttae. So this is the picture of the guttae. And this is with another camera. This is a better quality camera. If you zoom in, you can see the guttae. You can see the hexagonal endothelial cells. See? You can take these photos. Things needed for gonioscopy, gonioscope, and rest you know already. I'm not going to go into this. This is glaucoma session for that. Pseudo-exfoliation, the angle on gonioscope. This is the same pseudo-exfoliation which you saw on slit on gonioscopy. This is also in gonioscopy. For gonioscopy, I prefer to take a video and then take out screenshots from there. You can also take photos which would give better quality images. In the same phone, photos give a better resolution than videos. That's another pro tip. If you're not getting the resolution you wanted, use photo mode. For fundus photos, we need a plastic bottle, which has to be empty. So if you take this bottle, empty this, fix it to an adapter. So I'll show you that. Or you can use these things. There's a do-it-yourself RedCam, which we published in 2016, which we used a PVC pipe, which basically looks like this, stuck it to the back of a smartphone case and used it. You can also get these commercial adapters, MI RedCam, Zeiss RedCam, HopeScope. This plastic bottle is the simplest one, which I want you all to go back home and do. Take a plastic bottle, empty it, cut the bottom, put the lens, put the phone, take photos, fundus photos. Once again, take a bottle, empty it, cut the bottom, put a lens, stick the phone case, take photos, fundus photos. So you can do fundus photography through slit lamp also, through a 90D with the adapter, fix the phone onto the slit lamp. You get photos like this. You can do fundus videography. That is the beauty of it. You can do fundus videography. This is a 90D. Saw the pseudo exfoliation. Some people missed it. There was pseudo exfoliation on the anterior lens capsule. Put a 90D and you can see the disc. The cost of the adapter is less than 1,000 rupees now. This is the Weiss ring. You can see it only on slit lamp. You can probably see it on a fundus camera, but you can see it better on a slit lamp because of the lighting. You can adjust the illumination so that you can see the Weiss ring. Again, Weiss ring, can you see it? Yes. So this is the other method. This is without any adapter, just hand and 20D, like not hand, smartphone and 20D. So this technique is also published. This is a patient who had a little bit of exudative RD here, but once you go here, you can see in supine position, it is shifting fluid. Large exudative RD. Same patient, 2 minutes apart, sitting and supine. Shifting fluid of exudative RD. You cannot do this on a fundus camera. And you can do many other methods. This was recently published with just an iPhone X, no financial interest. You can take without any lenses, just directly you can take. This was published in JAMA Ophthalmology, I think, a couple of months back. You can, I already mentioned this, slit photos, you can take phacolytic cells floating around. So I think my time is up, so I will shift to the next topic in 3, 2, 1, and next.